Video 1, candle tomato. Video 2, coming up, banana bottle. This is the Phantom V2511. This is the ultra slow motion workhorse for smarter every day.
And sometimes on the slow-mo guys.
This camera can record at 2/3 of a million frames per second, but you'll notice there's no microphone on it. So the question we always get in the comments is, how do you record sound so slow? Do you do it at an ultrasonic frequency or something like that? And the answer is no. Welcome back to the garage, where we shoot stuff and do fun things. There's a question I always get on Smarter Every Day when I do a slow motion video, and it's, how did you record the sound? Did you record the sound with the camera and then play it back? A lot of people don't realize that when you're recording with slow motion, it's just images. So today, Gordon from Canada, the guy that does all the magic with the slow motion, is actually here. Thank you for coming, Gordon.
Thanks for having me.
All right, so I'm gonna challenge you today.
Okay.
You up for that?
Yes.
So you know nothing about what we're gonna do, correct?
No.
Okay, so we have a gun, we've got some stuff here. I'm gonna record several things in slow motion and then let Gordon walk you through what it's like to design slow motion sound. Because you do that for pretty much every Smarter Every Day with slow motion, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you're good at it.
Unless there's good voiceover over top or something, yeah.
Yeah, okay, cool. So challenge number one, a rifle going to be putting out a candle. What do you think about that?
That would be great. So, we are going to record the sound because one of the questions we always get is, can you just record the sound in real time and slow it down? The answer is no, which we'll explain later.
Are you ready? 3, 2, 1. Oh, it didn't go out. That makes your sound harder.
Yeah.
Okay, it moved.
Like, the flame moved, but it didn't go out. So, you can make sound for that, right?
We can make sound for that.
Oh, look at that. It went all the way out.
It did go all the way out.
That was high speed challenge number one. Roland, what are you doing?
So we're doing some science.
Yeah.
I thought we could probably learn a lot of things by coring this tomato and putting an M90 in it, which is 10 bigger than an M80.
What are those units? Do you know? So this is the M90. I didn't even know M90s were a thing.
Neither did I.
All right.
They're super illegal in Canada.
Really?
Well, probably not super. I have messed around with them, but I think they were brought up from Mexico somehow.
We need to protect ourselves from the, yeah. Oh, wow. So you're just gonna...
I'm gonna get it right in there. I want the fuse coming out the top. Though, do we have to be careful not to wet the fuse, probably? Or does gunpowder not care?
I don't think it cares.
Okay.
So what are you doing here?
You're gonna
put it out the top.
Yeah, I want it.
And you're gonna put the plug back in the bottom?
I guess we could, huh? I came to Alabama for new experiences. It's like a birthday tomato.
Oh! What do you think?
Yeah, I'm not sure if I want to put my face there.
Okay.
Or how much the tomato's gonna cushion the blow.
Do you want me to do it? I'll totally do it.
If you guys are around a lot more exploding things than me, and if you think that is a safe...
I'll go first. And you gotta promise me you're gonna make amazing slow-mo sound for this.
Yeah, I'll spend a little extra time on this.
Really?
Yeah.
Promise?
Yes.
Okay, thanks. Here we go. Oh, snap!
What's going on?
It wasn't that bad. It was like nothing hit me.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
It's gonna look so good though.
Oh, that's great. That's awesome. It's gonna look good and it was safe.
You have a seed right on your face.
What?
Your nose right here.
Yeah, really? Where? Okay. Where'd it go?
I think you got it.
I think I got it. Okay, so how are you gonna make the sounds for that?
I mean, we'll probably use some tomato sounds.
Oh!
Holy cow!
That's awesome.
Might do a little more than just tomato sound.
So what would you do with the light?
I don't know. We'll probably get creative. I think like a really encapsulated, sort of occluded concussion, like a sort of thing.
Oh, really?
Pretty cool. We'll record slow tomato sounds that are more they're going to match the footage a bit better.
So you record the tomato sounds and then...
We'll get another tomato and we'll just like squish it up and throw it around and manipulate it.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
That'd be nice.
Add a bunch of processing, reverb, pitch it down so it feels slow.
What, you pitch it down so it feels slow?
Yeah, yeah.
Huh.
Because that's just psychoacoustically, that's what we want.
It's at this part in the process where I have to get the slow motion files off of the flash that's here on the camera, download it, and then push it over the internet to Gordon and let him work his magic. For the first video, The Candle, Gordon has all the sounds he needs in a library of previously recorded stuff, so he simply watches the video and he lays these sounds down on the track as he sees fit. However, when he does new stuff, like the tomato exploding, sometimes he has to record new sounds, and he was so gracious as to record this incredibly complicated and precise process for us.
For the tomato, I'm not actually going to use a tomato. There's a technical reason for that. I'm going to use an orange, and that's because I looked in the fridge and I didn't have a tomato, and I thought I did, and the grocery stores are closed. So we're going to use an orange. It's another very juicy fruit. I've squished tomatoes before, I've squished oranges before. They're pretty much the same thing when it comes to sound. Believe it or not, I was one of the smart kids at the school.
After he's recorded the new sounds, they're edited, then they're cleaned up for imperfections, and then brought into the session, they're cut to the picture, and then they're processed as one overall sound. Then, after he finishes all the magic, this is the final product. Alright, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Smarter Every Day. It was sponsored by Audible. I love Audible audiobooks. It helps me reclaim my commute and get smarter while I'm doing it. You really should be listening to audiobooks, and Audible is the best way to do that. You can go to audible.com/smarter, get any free book you want as a trial, but I recommend this one, Letters to a Young Scientist by E.O. Wilson. He's a Pulitzer Prize winning biologist that's taught at Harvard for years. It's a great book. If you're a young person and you're getting into the sciences, go check out Letters to a Young Scientist by E.O. Wilson. The way you can get this is going to audible.com/smarter, or there's actually a new way. If you text the word smarter to the phone number 500-500, they will reply with a link so that you can sign up for a free trial. It's awesome. Anyway, that's pretty cool. Really neat way to do that. So audible.com/smarter or text smarter to 500-500. And if you want to see all the books that I like, I'll leave a link down in the video description so you can check that out. This was video 1 of 2. The next one is going to be Banana Bottle. So I hope you stick around and maybe subscribe so you can see that video. I'm Destin. You're getting smarter every day. Have a good one. Oh wait, is the audio recording?
What's happening?
I'm crying, man.
This is so scary.